Yes, children, good morning. So let us see the levels of organization. So living organisms do not live in isolation. So they don't like to live alone. Any living organism we take, right from smaller organisms to higher organisms, they don't like to live alone. They don't like it, living in isolation. They always coexist with each other. So what happens? They require the support of each other. Alone they cannot live, so they require support, help and other things from each other. There are two levels of organization, and they are, so you find two levels of organization. One is the lower level of organization. Lower level means which consists of very smaller organisms. See, lower level of organization are subdivided into five levels. Lower level itself is divided into five divisions. What are they? Cells, tissues, organs, organ system and organism. Already this in the previous class you have learned, the first class itself you have learned. So the lower levels of organizations are subdivided into five levels, like cell level, tissue level, organs level, organ system level and organism. So here you can see this is a cell, already you know, animal cell, how it is, no? Then group of similar cells joined together to perform a particular function is called tissues. Single cell, group of cells will form tissues. Group of tissues of similar type will join, which performs a specific function, we call it as organ. Then group of organs of same type will join together to form organ system. So here you can see excretory system. Okay. So then finally what happens, with all these things together there is an organism. You can see man. Understood? So first is a cell. Group of cells of same type will join together to form tissues. Group of tissues will join together to form organs. Group of organs will join to form organ system. And group of organ systems together, many organ systems will be there in our body. This is only one excretory system. Circulatory system, respiratory system, digestive system, like that. There are so many systems. And they all consist of different organs. So finally all this together, put together, what happens? There will be an organism. Now coming to higher levels of organization. Under higher levels of organization, higher levels of organizations are subdivided into the following categories, like population, community, ecosystem, biome and biosphere. See, higher, lower level of what happens, cell, tissue, organ, organ system and organism is formed, right? But when you come to higher levels, many different, that is many organisms of the same type, means many human beings together, because here is a human being. Many human beings put together, then you call that as population. You understand? Similar type of human, human beings means one type. Maybe they are in Africa or America or whatever it is, maybe white looking or fair looking or maybe dark complexion, whatever it is. But they are all human beings. So all these human beings put together, we call that as population. Okay? Now community. Community means what? Different races. Now for example here, we can say Africans will say. Why? They look different from Indians. You observe? Americans look different. So that you can take the different categories. You take it as community. Ecosystem means where these people will have an interaction with the nature. With the nature. Now for example, we are getting oxygen from, where are we getting oxygen? We are getting from the environment, isn't it? So we are having a contact with the environment. From where are we getting food? We are getting from the environment by growing plants, isn't it? So like that, water, where are we getting? It is got from the nature. So there is an interaction between the living organism and non-living things in the environment. You got it? There is an interaction of living organisms for air, water, food and all those things. Living organisms are depending on the environment for their survival. That is what you call it as ecosystem. Biome means, now if you take oceans is one type, deserts is one type, isn't it? Ocean, if you take oceans it is of one type, desert is one type, if you take grassland that is one type, understood? So like this, no, in the nature itself you have got so many divisions. That is called as biome. And all this put together, population, community, ecosystem, biome, all that put together is biosphere. Then what is biosphere? The whole world. The whole world is called as the biosphere. You understood? Population means, now for example, only tigers are there. Only tigers. You call that as tiger population. Only rabbits are there. Many are there. Then you call it as rabbit population. Understood? Human means if you take human population. Means organisms of the same type or same species is called as population. Community understood? Difference in, now for example, plants. In plants you can see shrubs will be one, herbs will be one, trees will be one. You understood? So that is all different communities. Okay? Then ecosystem. Ecosystem means wherein the living organisms are having a contact with the surrounding or the environment for their survival, like air, water, food and all those things. Then that is called as the ecosystem. Biome means the various types of categories present in the whole world, like grasslands, deserts, then water sports and all those things. So that is called as biome. Coming to biosphere, everything put together is biosphere, the whole world. You can understand? Earth. Now you see here, population. What population you can see here? It is human population. So human population put together, what happens? They are in contact with the surroundings. See? Now you can see here animal. Animal is eating the grass. This animal will be eaten by other carnivorous animals. Isn't it? Again they will be, after they are dead, what happens? The decomposers act on them. And then after decomposers acting, what happens? This minerals which is present in their body is going back to the soil only. What is happening? So that is the, you can see different types of communities here. And finally, they are having an interaction with the non-living things. So that is called as the ecosystem. And finally, you can see various types of categories. Then desert separate, water separate, like that if you get, no? You call it as different types of biomes. And comes the whole earth. You can see it is the whole earth. What is that? Biosphere. Bio means living, you should understand. Bio means living. So, what is sphere then here? The globe, the earth. How is earth? Earth is spherical in shape, right? So, on earth you can see the living body. That is why you call it as biosphere. Did you understand this part? Okay, now let us go for the next one. Coming to unicellular organisms. Already it is understood, uni means single cell. The single cell itself is going to carry all the life processes. In unicellular or single cell organisms, the single cell performs all life functions and it functions independently. The cell itself is carrying out all the life processes independently. So it is called as unicellular organism. They are so small that they cannot be seen with the naked eye. We cannot see. Very, very minute. I told you 1 micron size. 1 micron means you cut that 1 millimeter of your scale into 1000 parts. You can understand how it is. Millimeter itself is small. If you cut that into 1000 parts, how it will be? It will be very, 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 very minute, which you cannot see with our naked eyes at all. Okay. And we require electronic microscope to observe that. Okay. So, see here. The single cell only performs all the functions independently. They are so small that they cannot be seen with our naked eye. Examples of unicellular organisms are sponges. Sponge here they are not given, which is found in the ocean, in the sea. You find that sponge. Okay, sponges. Spirogyra. This is Spirogyra. You can see like tape-like structure. VV shaped it is. Okay. So, Spirogyra. Wall box. Wall box means they are living in colonies. Means they all group together and live in colonies. Grouping together. So that is wall box. Then Pandorina. So Pandorina also they are not given. Other than that, they have again Paramecia and it is amoeba. It is a shapeless organism. Understood? So these are all having unicellular organism. Means single cell organism. Coming to multicellular organisms. Multicellular means many cell. Many cell organisms have various levels of organization within them. Individual cells may perform specific functions and also work together for the good of the entire organism. So individual cells may perform specific function. Now for example, individual cells here. Now for example, if you take the skin part only. In skin only, you find so many millions of cells will be there. And every cell put together, it is going to be a cell, skin. It is going to be skin. You understood? Now if you take heart. In heart, you see cardiac cells. They join together to form cardiac tissue. Then they form the heart, which is an organ. Understood? Like that, individual cells may perform specific functions and also work together for the good of the entire organism. There are so many cells in their body, but each cell is independently working and it has got a specific function to carry on. The cells become dependent on one another. Multicellular, the cells become dependent on one another. Means what? Now, for example, so you are taking what is that? Air. Will that air remain in your body like that only? No. What is going to happen? The oxygen of that will go and start oxidizing the food materials. So food comes under digestion. Oxygen comes under respiration. Now respiratory system and digestive system, they have got a coordination. And after digesting, what happens? That food will enter into the blood. The simplified food is going to enter into the blood in the form of glucose. Now blood, what does the blood? The blood is going to carry all these materials to the whole body. So it is required the support of circulation also, isn't it? Digestive system is taking support of respiratory system, it is taking support of circulatory system, it is taking support of excretory system. Like that, every system of our body, though they are working independently, they are depending on each other. Got it? So their cells become dependent on one another. Multicellular organisms have the following 5 levels of organization, ranging from simplest to complex, most complex, simplest to most complex. Level 1. Under level 1, if you take, see, only cells are there. Only cells. Cells are the basic units of structure and function in living organism. Already in the previous class you have learned it. What is a cell? Cells are the basic units of structural and functional unit. It is a graph life. So they serve a specific function within the organism. Some examples of cells are blood cells, nerve cells, bone cells, etc. Blood cell is different from bone. You have seen blood. Is it same like bone? No. Bone is very hard, isn't it? White in color. But this one is reddish in color because of presence of hemoglobin. So like that, you see, nerve cells. Nerve. When somebody takes a pin and just picks, what happens? You will start shouting, no, how you say? Why?